Sige, first question. Okay. Regarding Colonel Espinido, no, leave it to us. It's purely an internal issue. I will deal with Espinido squarely as the chief PNP and he being a member of the PNP. No comment. I will deal with it internally. Okay. We will deal with the issue internally. Other questions, please. Yes, there's an explanation of the ABSI Group director. Hindi ko pa nabasa, no? But nevertheless, ano naman kasi, the CIDG was tasked to enforce it. No? So, baka yun lang hindi na-inform. But, you know, the ultimate, the ultimate objective was for the former senator to surrender and post-pay.
There's no big deal about it.
Ah, no, not much an issue.
Sir, nasa na tayo sa level ng adjudication ng 356.
Okay.
Start na ba siya?
Yes, the national, I had a meeting yesterday with the director of intelligence. They have already started adjudicating. As a matter of fact, there's an initial recommendation. But of course, this will be contained in the final recommendation they're going to make. And we'll be having a joint command conference with the President and the AFP on March 5. And I intend to submit my recommendation on March 5. No, kahapon, bumaba ang breakdown to 4 to 19, ano? To 19. So ito yung ito talaga yung hindi nagpakita, no? But the balance of the 43 minus 19, I told them, look, the only excuse they're going to have is when they can present a medical certificate that they have been admitted or what. Now, for the past 3 days after I required them to attend, there was no such notice that was given to me. So, nevertheless, we're going back to the 43 for them to be marked awol and be investigated. As a matter of fact, sabi ko sa kanila, let's go ahead with the other validation and adjudication first. Then, saka na yung mga nag-awol. But, nevertheless, all the 357 will still undergo adjudication.
Sir, yung dalawang frontman na sa upot sa gizin?
Yung ano, dalawang?
Frontman.
Yes?
Pinalayan ng upot sa gizin sa
ano kasi, no? When you take a person under custodial investigation, it's that time allowed by law, number of hours only, for you to gather evidences. But if there's nobody who's going to execute an affidavit, who has personal knowledge over it, it will go into a regular filing. Hindi siya pwedeng i-inquest. Kasi hindi pwedeng ikulong mo yung tao nang wala ka na pa-file na charge because we will be charged also for illegal detention. So some of the circumstances, ganito ang nangyari. So kung talagang walang magwi-witness, who has personal knowledge over the incident, later on, we will gather evidences which are purely circumstantial. So there are restrictions when you investigate. Hindi ibig sabihin na nahuli mo siya, tapos right away, pwede mo na siyang i-detain. Remember, we have a reglamentary period for us to file a case. Otherwise, kailangan bitawan. Bitawan, tawag din bitawan. Palaya. Yes, that's a general general instruction, no? Sabi ko nga, as a matter of fact, we're coming in with a social media protocols for PNP personnel, no? Because you have to resort to your own our own internal mechanism. So why is Espinido? That's why I will deal with him internally. Not yet. Not yet. That's why he will be investigated.
Sir, papatawag din si Carlos Espinosa?
No.
No. Pero ito pinsan na i-violated na parang...
That's jumping to conclusion. Putting words into my mouth.
Yes.
Next topic, please.
Sir, related to legal public, it is that you've been very aggressive against legal public and may mga na-confiscate na mga pero it was also done before. So, parang it's not included. So, at the level ng high value packet na in terms of gambling significant.
Yes, yes. In the next few months, heads will roll. No? If you don't follow my instruction, no take, and you're not going doing anything to stop illegal gambling. I have given the regional directors all the names that were, you know, forwarded to me by different sources. And if you don't do anything about it, you'll be answerable for inaction.
Sir, how many illegal gambling?
Marami, marami. And then peculiar for each different region. No? Merong regions na by provinces, merong region na buong region. So, all of these naman are identified.
When it comes to big syndicates, yung talagang player?
Yeah, we're going against them. Yes. Pag sinabi kong illegal gambling, walang definition. Walang ibang definition. Lahat ng illegal gambling. From low to high. Yeah, we have a list per region. First, do not take anything from it. Second, do aggressive operations to convince me that you're not receiving something. Because if you don't do aggressive operations and you don't start relieving your chiefs of police, then I will not be convinced that you're doing something about it. Of course, hindi important yun. When you go for a campaign, para totohanan yan, dapat may kasong ipa-file.
Sir, categorically, yung investigation mga without preempting the results.
Next question. Next question.
Sir, clarification on the previous visits. Yan ba 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 ba
ba ba ba ba sinabi ko naman, 356 yun. At 357, 356. Kasi may namatay na isa. Hindi, natural yun ano, kasi pag merong thriving na illegal gambling, natural yun na may nagpoprotekta, di ba? Hindi naman yun magta-thrive kung hinuhuli ng pulis. And ito nga ang sinasabi ko dun sa mga illegal gamblers, sa mga players, na huminto na kayo. Huminto na kayo. Anyway, yun lang naman pakiusap ko, huminto na kayo eh. Otherwise, you will face the full force of the law. Hindi natin sigurado yan. No? Kaya continuing yan. Sinasabi ko nga, our counterintelligence, if you've heard kanina no, sa IMEG, we will strengthen it some more. I'm even thinking of, kasi pag umiikot sila, kasama na ng IMEG yung Internal Affairs Service, who will take charge of the administrative filing of cases. So we will strengthen that and find out yung mga, even those who are protecting illegal gambling. Hindi, kasi yung recent reshuffle was based on the take. No? Pero yung protection, medyo wala pa kaming matibay na basihan.
Sir, question lang. What prompted you to renew the drive against illegal gambling? Is it because ilalabot mo masyado sa drugs mo at nakalimutan na kung naglaroon ng mga
gambling? Yeah, alam nyo, even before, maraming mga officers ng PNP na nasangkot doon sa illegal drugs, not knowing that the money coming from illegal gambling were already mixed with illegal drug money. No? And hindi ko naman sinasabi na existing yan ngayon. No? But nevertheless, ano kasi, this is part of internal cleansing. Eh? We have to convince the people that we're serious on everything. No? That the PNP does not protect on any illegal activities that other citizens do. Ito yung drive ko. Kaya nga sabi ko, ang unahin ko talaga sa administration ko is internal cleansing. No? Kaya nga in-announce ko kanina, halos lahat ng policy directive namin is towards strengthening our human resources. No? That's why we conduct study, we improve our competency training. It's good that the PNP and the NPTI are already with the PNP. So there's much to do with our human resources. And all of this is sa, para maging maayos yung ating mga kapulisan. Of all sorts. Hindi ko muna sabihin ang figure. But we have those who are protecting, those who are engaged in other illegal activities, not only gambling, not only drugs. It's part of counterintelligence in any armed component. Even the AFP and the PNP has that. Okay? Thank you. Thank you.